like recommending with seated position is to have your towel or a blanket underneath your seat bones. If you have a yoga block, you could even sit on your yoga block, but if not, no worries. Just find your comfortable seated position. And the reason I like to have a little bit of a prop underneath is to allow for your seat bones to roll forward. So that gives you the opportunity to let your crown reach high towards the sky. Seated can mean on your knees, your legs could be straight out in front of you, whatever is comfortable for you today. And then allow yourself to just begin to count your breaths. Allow yourself to begin to sink into the sensation of your body. Allow yourself to find a little bit of anchoring through those seat bones as you find a little bit of levity through the crown of your head. Now to call out the dog in the room, we do have Augie here today, so he might make his presence known throughout the class, and he might say hello with his voice from time to time, but just to be aware of that. And now what I would like you to do is begin to close your eyes or let your gaze go fuzzy, either finding a drishti point, a point of unmoving, unfocusing energy in front of you, or with eyes closed, begin to focus in on that third eye center, that inner landscape, and begin to allow your breath to wash over any sensation, any thoughts, anything that is taking you out of this moment, away from your mat, away from this time, away from your presence, and allow your exhale to just release that into space. Inhale, feel your seat bones grow roots a little bit deeper, crown reaches a little bit higher. Exhale brings you into this moment. As always, I invite you to find whatever intention is calling to you, whatever is speaking to you today. But for me personally, it has happened to me actually twice this week where I will be taking a little bit of an earth energy break, taking Augie out for a walk, and out of nowhere, we've gotten stuck in the rain twice. It's halfway through our walk, so it's too far to turn around and come back, and we just have to rush home. And in those moments of unpredictable things that are out of your control, it's easy to have an emotional reaction. And all it takes, though, is to check that emotional reaction and find the perspective of it is out of your control, and it is just an opportunity to giggle at yourself, to enjoy your frizzy hair and enjoy the sensation of being in these springtime rains, and find the joy in that and find the happiness in that rather than the frustration. And quite literally, Augie just shakes it off and goes on his way. So I thought that was a fun message to bring into the sensation of our practice. And it's something I have been practicing on my mat today. So if that is speaking to you, finding that little bit of a shift in perspective, that opportunity to find joy when emotion is high, or whatever intention is speaking to you, let's take a big breath into that space. Inhale, feel your ribs separate, filling up your lungs, letting that breath go all the way down into your belly as your crown reaches tall, seat bones root in. Take one more tiny little sip up at the top. Open mouth exhale, let it go. On your next inhale breath, gently let your eyes flutter open. And let's start finding some movement through our sensation by finding some nice big shoulder rolls. Get your arms into it. You can do one and then the other. Washy movements, whatever is calling to you, whatever is speaking to you. Now take it the opposite direction, really allowing every point of this rotation to have sensation. Move with intention, with ease, with slowness. Now finding your shoulders rotating up to your ears, rolling back, feel your shoulder blades sink at the back and then drop them down. feeling the release, the relaxation in our shoulders, keeping that sensation throughout class today. We're going to find a lot of heart opener, a lot of shoulder love, and so we're going to focus in on that. Your inhale breath, reach your fingertips towards the sky, reach them tall. And then on your exhale, let your right hand reach towards the outside of your left knee. Left hand just comes back behind you as a brace. Keeping that relaxed sensation of your shoulders, we're not shrugging them up towards our ears. And now find three big breaths. As you inhale, crown grows tall. As you exhale, maybe you find a little bit more availability into that space. Two more like that. I like to envision, inhale, you're filling up, you're creating space. And then as you exhale, you allow your muscles and your sensation to melt in there. One more. Go to your edge, your limit, your point of sensation, avoiding pain. But maybe even let your gaze fall back an inch. On your next inhale breath, come back through midline. Fingertips reach tall. As you exhale, opposite side. Left hand falls to the outside of right knee. Right hand comes behind you just as a brace. And then begin to gaze backwards, three breaths here, recognizing different sensations, second side, not shrugging our shoulders, using your exhales to melt into that space you've created with your inhale. Take one more big breath on this side, letting that exhale melt. On your next inhale, come back through mid, fingertips reach tall. Getting into that heart space, cactus your arms, gaze up, open up through that chest space, little baby back bend. Next inhale breath, reach those fingertips forward, and then let them come to rest on your mat in front of your shins. Gently rolling over knees or sweeping those knees out to the side, making our way into a nice, comfortable tabletop position. Again, finding a little bit of shoulder love. On your inhale breath, let that left hand really sink deep down into the mat while you let your right hand fly up and open. Finding a nice little gentle twist to start here. You can find some flamingo fingers, rotate through your wrist. And then as you exhale, thread the needle. Right hand comes underneath your left shoulder. Now you can let your right ear just rest down on the mat. Options for left hand. It can rest on the mat in front of you. You can walk it forward, finding a nice big side opener. Or if you're craving a little bit of a twist, you can reach it high and then let it come to rest at the low spine or even reaching for that right quad. Whichever variation you're taking, give yourself two more big breaths into this space. Breathing into your points of sensation. Exhales allow you to melt. And then just recognize the difference in perception here, the difference in support and shape of your body while allowing yourself to melt. On your next inhale breath, return that left hand back to neutral position, what will be underneath shoulder. Press into that left hand, reach that right hand high, rotate it out, twist it out. And then as you exhale, hands come back to neutral tabletop, knees directly underneath hips, make any modifications or adjustments you need to. Now let that right hand really melt down into the earth. As you inhale, that left hand flies up and open. Find those nice little flamingo fingers rotating through your wrist. And then as you exhale, melt that left hand underneath right shoulder, finding the same variation you did on the opposite side, either letting your hand just rest in front of your face, walking it forward for a nice big side stretch, or if you did so on the other side, reach it tall and then reach it back behind you for your left quad. Whichever variation you're taking though, allow yourself to find your breath, to find the ease, and to find this perception shift. This might be a difficult posture. It may be hard to breathe. It might be hard to find that perception. So allowing yourself to find the ease in these moments. And it might feel really great. That's another perception you can take. on your next inhale breath, gently walk your hands back underneath that neutral position and breathe that left hand high. As you exhale, hands come back down to neutral tabletop, finding some cat-cows. We've opened up our shoulders. We've moved our spine in a rotation. Now let's find an expansion and contraction. Contraction first. Let your belly drop, gaze lift, big inhale breath. Exhale, curl it up and in. Press through those fingertips, press through those knees, expanding through the entire vertebrae. Twice more like that. Inhale, drop your belly, lift your gaze. Use your entire inhale breath. Fill up that front side of your body. And then as you exhale, vacuum seal your belly up to your spine, really using that exhale breath to create the space to open up on the backside. Once more, your breath, your flow, collarbones shine, opening up, feel almost like there's a stretch in your core. And then exhale, same amount of sensation on the backside of your body. Next inhale breath. Find that balance between cat and cow, engaging both front and back side of your body. Walk your palms forward about a palm width distance, and then step your toes back. Feet as wide as hips, maybe a little bit wider, coming into our strong plank pose. We're breathing here. We're not sinking into our low spine. We're not sinking into shoulders. We're staying nice and engaged. Engage your quads, your core. Press up through your chest. Puff up through the back side of your body. And then on your exhale, take your time, slow as you can go through plank, or you can drop to knees and let your elbows graze your rib cage, coming all the way down to belly. Once you're there, let the tops of your toes press down into the mat. Really find engagement here, so much so you feel your knees lift up and off the earth. We're gonna find a super cobra variation today. So let your hands come out of a T, untented fingertips, and this just allows our heart and our chest to really open up. So press in with your toes, engage your low spine, inhale, press it up, super cobra, exhale, release. We got two more breaths like that. Forehead comes all the way to the mat on your exhale. Inhale, legs back, arms, super cobra, use your fingertips. Roll with your exhale, forehead all the way to mat. Check in with the sensation, the perception, your intention. Once more. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, melt all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae, then forehead presses into mat. Let those toes curl under, come back to the mat. Hands come back underneath shoulders. Engage all those muscles, pressing it up through that plank or tabletop, and then let your hips travel high and back into our first official downward facing dog. Take some time here to set it up. Wag your tail, rotate through your ankles, pedal through your feet, come up onto your tippy toes, let your heart melt down with really bent knees. Whatever splashy movements are calling to you, let yourself take the chance to find this downward facing dog today. It might be your first downward facing dog of the week. It might be the 50th of the week, but just letting this be your sensation here and now. Now check in with your perception of down dog. Check in with the sensation here, allowing yourself to find the joy, to find the ease in this active resting pose. So it is first and foremost active. We're pressing in with our fingers. We're pressing back with our heels, opening up to our hamstrings. But it is a resting posture, so find the joy in that. Let's find a little bit of breath to body movement. Kick up the heat a little bit. On your inhale breath, let your right leg lift high to the sky. Really reach it tall. As you exhale, pull your knee into belly, into chest. We're looking at our right thumb and we're gently stepping it through. You can use your hand to get there if you need to. We're going to drop down to our back knee on this variation. And if you have props available, go ahead and find them. If you don't, you can use fingertips, no big deal. From here, we're going to inhale, press into our props. Find a nice straight spine. Crown is reaching tall. And then as you exhale, gently tick-tock your hips back until your back knee is at 90 degrees. So we're allowing our hips to just be in line with our knee. We're not sinking back. We're not curling through our spine. We're staying nice and lifted. Now pull your right toes back towards your nose. Should feel like a lot of sensation on the backside of your body. And again, this is where the props come in handy to keep that spine straight, but fingertips on mat is perfectly fine too. On your inhale breath, crown reaches tall. And then as you exhale, bend into your elbows. Any amount, even if it's an inch, even if it's a millimeter, find a little bit more sensation here. Flowing breaths of movement. Inhale, find your halfway lift. Keep those right toes pulling back. Exhale, bend into your elbows. Breathe into the sensation. Perceiving the backsides of our bodies, the hamstrings, our Achilles. Once more. Inhale, halfway lift. Heart is tall and proud. Exhale, bend into your elbows. On your next inhale breath, gently walk your fingertips or props forward, coming back through low lunge. Hands return to the mat. Engage through that back leg. Inhale, step it back, plank pose. Take a beat here, feel the power, feel this opportunity. And then as you exhale through tabletop or plank, low as you can go, all the way to belly. Top to toes, press in, tend to fingertips out at the side. One super cobra breath. Inhale. And then as you exhale, return your forehead to the mat. Give your intention a little nod, a little attention. Changing this perspective, finding the joy. Hands return underneath your shoulders. Inhale, press it up through plank or tabletop. Hips lift high and back. Reset breath. Inhale into those hips. Exhale, melting your heart. Inhale breath, left leg lifts tall. Second side. With control, use your core. Pull your knee into belly, into chest. Looking at that left thumb. Gently step it through. Back knee comes down to the mat. Finding your props if you did so on the other side or just fingertips. Inhale, press in, find that halfway lift. Crown is nice and tall. And then as you exhale, we're gonna tick-tock our hips back over knee, staying nice and lifted through our hips. Pull those left toes back towards your nose. Inhale, press into fingertips, chest lifts high. Exhale, bend your elbows any amount, an inch, a millimeter, just to the point of sensation in our hamstrings. Twice more like that. Inhale, pull your toes back towards your nose. Crown lifts tall. Big inhale breath. Exhale, melt. Once more. Inhale, find that halfway lift. Pull your toes back. Half splits here, really getting into our hamstrings. Backside of our body perception. Exhale, find that nice, gentle release by bending your elbows. Inhale breath, walk it forward, moving props out of the way if you have them. Engage through that back leg. Inhale, step it back, plank pose, take a beat here, find that power. And then as you exhale, slow descent all the way to your belly. Tops your toes, press in, fingertips reach out wide, tented fingertips. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, release. Inhale, press it up through plank or tabletop, hips high and back, down dog. Use this as a perception shift, breathe into the power. Exhale into the ease, find the rest. Moving up from the ground, growing high. Inhale, that right leg lifts tall. Exhale, yet again, we're looking at our right thumb. Moving with ease, with control, gently step it through, finding that right thumb. Staying active in our back leg this time, staying active and lifted. On your inhale breath, option to use your props yet again. You can press in, find that halfway lift. And on your exhale, straighten, any amount with that front leg, even if it's just a sensation, even if looking in a mirror doesn't move at all, as long as you feel a little bit more sensation, press through that front leg. Inhale, come into that low lunge, heart reaches through, here comes Augie's voice. As you exhale, straighten any amount through that front leg, crown is reaching towards your toes. Once more, inhale, come into that neutral lunge, shine that heart. Exhale, press it through, finding your way into your pyramid pose. Next inhale, breath, gently walk those props forward, coming back through neutral lunge. Step it back, plank pose. As you exhale, find your way all the way to your belly. Tops your toes, press in, fingertips out wide. Inhale, press it up, super cobra. Exhale, release. Inhale, breath, pressing it up through that plank or tabletop. Hips high and back. Downward facing dog. Perception shift. Inhale into the area of sensation. Exhale into the softness. On your inhale breath, left leg reaches tall. As you exhale, pull that knee to belly, to chest. Looking at that left thumb, gently stepping it through, using your hand to get there if you need to. Now using your props or tented fingertips, inhale, shine that heart, opening up through the front side. Exhale, straightening that front leg, any amount. Keep those hips on straight. Inhale, come back through neutral. Exhale, any amount through that front leg. Again, it can be a millimeter, letting your crown reach down towards your toes. We got one more. Inhale, shine that heart, coming back through neutral. Exhale, straightening that front leg, any amount. Next inhale, breath brings our palms back down to the mat, moving props out of the way. Step it back into your plank pose. Take your time, moving slow with control. Elbows graze your ribs, come all the way to belly. Tap your toes, press in. Tented fingertips out at the side. Inhale, breath, legs back, arms. Super cobra. Exhale, release. On your inhale, press it up through plank or tabletop. Let those hips lift high and back. Downward facing dog. Reset breath here. Inhale into those hips, lift it tall. Exhale, soften that perception, soften that mind, find the joy. On your inhale breath, right leg lifts high to the sky, reach it tall. As you exhale, take your time, knee to belly, to chest. This time we're looking right in between our thumbs. Gently step it through, right in the middle. Back heel gets heavy, big movement. We're gonna cartwheel all the way up into our standing five-pointed star. Toes are gonna come in towards each other. We're gonna pigeon toe in towards each other. Reach those fingertips tall. And then as you exhale, swan dive it all the way down into your wide-legged forward fold. Prasarita. Once you're there, let the crown of your head get heavy. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. Let the entire vertebrae find some nice traction here. Releasing, no muscles hanging on. And now on your inhale breath, find your hands underneath your shoulders. Reach that crown forward. Find a halfway lift here. Exhale, release it all the way. Let that crown go all the way towards the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, melt. Automatically just letting those muscles release. Crown reaches towards the floor. Once more. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, melt into that forward fold. on this inhale, swoop it up and around, gather all that energy, reach a tall five-pointed star. Exhale, cartwheel it towards the top of your mat. Back that back heel pops up. Inhale, step it back, plank pose. And then with control, make your way all the way to belly. Take your time, entire exhale breath. Tops of your toes press in, fingertips out wide. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, release, forehead all the way to mat. Inhale, press it up through plank or tabletop. Hips lift high and back. Downward facing dog. Inhale into your intention. Exhale into the ease. Inhale, that left leg lifts high to the sky. As you exhale, pull that knee to belly, to chest. Yet again, looking at that space right between our hands. Drop that back heel towards the mat. Big movement. Inhale, cartwheel it all the way up and open. Five-pointed star. Toes reach in towards each other. This time, we're going to let our hands come back towards the base of our back, finding a single fist, opening up through our shoulders, breathing into our chest. Big inhale breath. Let that single fist get heavy. And then as you exhale, swan dive with that clasp maintained. If you get here and your body says no thank you, your shoulders, your upper torso, wherever you might be feeling pain, you can just release those hands to the low back, or you can come all the way back down to neutral prasarita. Whichever variation feels right for you, permission to find whichever sensation. The clasp will allow for those shoulders to open if it is available to you today. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. Inhale, breathe into any point of sensation, chest, shoulders, upper torso. And then as you exhale, maybe melt your head a little bit closer. A little bit more minor adjustments here, minor breath. Inhale, maybe into hamstrings, into a feeling. Keep that exhale soften. Keep that one more breath here. Whatever sensation you need, even close your eyes. Find the joy, the softness in that exhale. On your next inhale, gently release those fists through that low spine. Let your shoulders come back, or your fingers come back underneath your shoulders. And then inhale, start with a halfway lift, and then swoop it up and around, five-pointed star. Exhale, cartwheel it towards the top of your mat. Pop that back heel up. Inhale, step it back, plank pose. With control, make your way all the way to belly. Tops your toes press in, fingertips out wide, tented fingertips. Inhale, breath, super cobra. Exhale, release. Forehead to the mat. Find that intention, that perception. Turn your hands back to shoulders. Let those toes curl under. Inhale, press it up. Hips high and back. Downward facing dog. Let's find three breaths here. You can find some nice gentle movements, some sways. You can allow yourself to find your breath. Allow yourself to find your intention, whatever is going to bring you ease in this moment. One more big breath here. Open mouth exhale. On your inhale, roll it forward, dropping your knees, making your way into your tabletop position. And then either curl over those ankles or sweep them around, making our way into a comfortable seat. Using your hands as a brace, grip through those knees. Use this as a prop to pull that chest up and tall. Crown is reaching high. And then as you exhale, melt down vertebrae by vertebrae, stone by stone, making your way all the way down onto your mat. On your inhale breath, bring your hands back behind your head, clasping the backs of your head as a gentle little hammock. Staying here, we're going to not want to scrunch our chin into our chest. We're not going to squish our neck. We're just using this as a brace. And then allow your feet to come up towards the ceiling. So we're pressing towards the ceiling, legs up the wall sensation, really activating through those hamstrings that we just opened up so much. And then on an inhale breath, release your right hand high. As you exhale, we're going to drop our right leg and tap our right fingers to our left toes. Inhale, come back through neutral, reach that fingertip high, legs come back to neutral, and then exhale, tap. Inhale, come back through neutral, staying on the same side, exhale, tap. Inhale, neutral, exhale, tap. Keep it going. Same side, same sensation. Using your inhales to stretch through neutral, exhales to tap. We've already got only five. Last four. Three. Last two. On one, hold it up there. We're gonna pulse it out. Pulse it out here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, let it go. Feet can come back to the mat. They can reach out. Maybe take some nice little windshield wipers with your knees. Whatever sensation is calling to you, give it to your body now before we move into second side. On your inhale, bring your hands back behind your head, just a hammock grip, keeping that neck nice and long. And then pull those legs up in space, legs go straight up the wall, pressing your feet towards the sky. Release that left hand, reach up overhead. And then as you exhale, drop that left leg, tap those right toes. Inhale, reach, return to neutral. Exhale, tap. Neutral. And exhale, tap. Keeping that nice breath going. Second side is always a little bit more fatigued. It does help out on the first side. So just give yourself permission here to feel the sensation. Listen to the second story. Keep it going. We've got five more. Last four. Last three. Two. You know it's coming up on one. Hold it up there. Pulse it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release those legs. Release those arms. Taking some nice windshield wipers. Keeping your feet pressed to the earth. Bent knees. As you inhale, come up through neutral. As you exhale, drop those knees to one side. Inhale through neutral. Exhale, drop to the opposite side. Once more each side. On your inhale breath, come back through neutral. Pull those knees into chest. Now gently rock side to side, giving that low spine a little bit of a massage. And then once you feel ready, begin to rock and roll up and down the length of your spine, gaining enough momentum that you can cross over your ankles, plant your hands, step back into our plank pose, and then just lift your hips high, reaching it back towards the sky, coming straight into downward facing dog. Now, just like we took a little lunar pause just a moment ago, let's find some activation in this down dog. As you inhale, press into those fingertips, really gripping the mat with those fingers. As you exhale, melt through your shoulders, through your heart, through that space. Two more big breaths. Breathe into your intention. Find that perspective shift especially after doing something that might require a little bit more attention, a little bit more energy, a little bit more strength. Use this as an opportunity to thank your body for the ability to do it. Thank your body for the progress it's on. It's all about perception. One more big breath. Open mouth, exhale. On your inhale, let your right leg lift high towards the sky, getting more into our strength section here. As you exhale, pull your knee into belly, into chest. Yet again, we're looking right in between our hands. We're gonna drop that back heel down. Inhale, cartwheel it up and open, landing in our warrior two as you exhale. This is our first time here, so we're gonna surf it out a little bit while opening up through our shoulders. As you inhale, swoop those hands up overhead, straightening through that front leg. Let your fingertips twist up over your head. Exhale, sit it low into that front leg, that right knee bends, reaching through warrior two. Twice more like that. Inhale, straighten through your front leg. Hands touch on top of head. Exhale, reach it out. Deep bend into that knee. Once more. Inhale, reach it high. Exhale, deep bend into that front knee, reach it out. Stay here for a breath. Feel the power. As you inhale, everything's expanding, making room. As you exhale, take up that space. Inhale, breath, flip that front palm. Reverse your warrior, reaching through that side body. And then as we exhale, we're gonna cartwheel it down towards the top of our mat. Pop that back heel up. So we're coming into our low lunge. Check in here, hips are gonna come back in line. So left hip is gonna drop down, right hip is gonna pull back in space. Opportunity for prop underneath your left hand, or you can press into the mat. As you inhale, breathe that right hand up and open for a revolved low lunge. As you exhale, hand comes back down to the mat, breathing through movement here, twice more like that. Inhale, press into that left hand, breathe that right hand up and open. Exhale, hand comes down to the mat. Once more. Inhale, find a little bit more of that rotation, just like opening, maybe just with your eyeballs, with your gaze. Exhale, come back through neutral. Little bit of a fun transition here. Walk those hands or props forward, hop that back foot up, coming into our standing split. So again, opportunity for props underneath those fingers to give you a little bit more brace, reaching that left hip tall while our hips are in alignment. So our left hip is dropping towards the earth, right hip is plugging back in, reaching through those left toes. Big breath here, crown is reaching towards the earth. As we exhale, we're gonna find a deep bend into both knees, clasping the back knee with the front. Jiva squat. Hands are staying on the earth as support. Inhale, kick it tall, standing splits. Two more Jiva squats. Exhale, curl into a tiny little ball, reach it through. Exhale, kick it tall, standing splits. One more. Inhale, and then as you exhale, curl it in. Inhale, kick it tall. Soft landing on your exhale. Find your way into your low lunge. Step it back, plank pose. Exhale with control through knees or through plank. Elbows graze your belt or your ribs all the way to belly. Tops your toes, press into the mat. Fingertips out wide. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, release that forehead to the mat. Check in with your perception. Check in with judgment, where your mind is. Hands come back underneath your shoulders. Opportunity to shift it if it's not serving you. Inhale, breath. Press it up through plank or tabletop. Hips high and back. Into your downward facing dog. Reset breath here. Inhale into those hips. Lift them tall. Exhale, soften through something, even if it's just your mind. Inhale, left leg reaches tall to the sky. Reach it high. As you exhale, take your time. Yet again, we're looking right in between our thumbs. Gently step it through. Back heel gets heavy. Inhale, cartwheel it up and open. Exhale, land into our warrior two. Surfing it out, first time here. Inhale, reach the fingertips tall, straighten through that front leg. Exhale, sit it low, reach those fingertips out wide. Two more. Inhale, straighten through the front leg. Fingertips reach tall. Check in with the story you're telling since you know where we're going. Exhale, sit low in that front leg. Once more. Inhale, reach it tall. Exhale, sit it low. Warrior two. We're here for a breath. Fill up with good. Fill up with joy. Exhale, find that power. Sit it low. Flip your front palm. Inhale, reverse that warrior, reaching through that side body. And then exhale, cartwheel it towards the top of our mat. Pop that back heel up, dropping that right hip down, plugging that left hip back and in. Right hand gets heavy either on the mat or on a prop. Inhale, breathe that left hand high. Nice twisted low lunge, revolved low lunge. Exhale, back to neutral. Inhale, reach it tall. Exhale, come back through neutral. Once more. Inhale, reach it tall. Take that twist a little bit deeper, even if it's just with your gaze. Exhale, come back through neutral. Walk those hands forward, hop that back foot up, coming into our standing split. Hips are neutral, right hip is heavy, left hip is plugging up and in. Activate your glutes and your hamstrings to lift that toe a little bit higher. Crown is heavy, crown is reaching towards the earth. Big inhale breath, fill up. Exhale, deep bend into both knees, curl it in, Jiva squat. Inhale, kick it tall. Exhale, Jiva squat. Inhale, fill it up. We've only got one more. Exhale, coil it in. Jiva squat. Little change coming up here. Inhale, kick it tall. This time, soft landing into your forward fold. Feet come to rest at the top of your mat. Inhale, extended halfway lift. Press into your shins. Crown reaches forward. Feel that elongation through that low spine, mid, all the way up into your upper spine and neck. Your cervical spine is reaching forward. Exhale, melt into your forward fold. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. Letting go of any tension that might have been built in that previous session. On your inhale breath, sweep it up and around all the way into standing mountain pose. Reach your fingertips tall. As you exhale, cactus your arms. Open up, baby back bend. Inhale, reach it tall. And coming into a little bit of a balancing section. Hands can come to heart or palms can press into chest. We're gonna start with our right leg on being lifted. So balancing on left leg. So kickstand through that right leg to start. And now energetically feel all four corners of our left foot pressing down into the mat. Feel the big toe mound, that knife edge of your foot, the heel, making sure you're on a stable, sturdy area. Now find your drishti point, a point of unmoving energy in front of you, coming into balance. Anytime your eyeballs cannot be moving, it helps with that balance. Now bring your right hand out to the side like you're holding a tray. So our thumb is pointing back, pinky is pointing forward. We're not gonna flip our tray over. We're not gonna rotate and close through our shoulders. We're gonna stay nice and open, little almost baby back bend here. So keeping that thumb pressing back, as you exhale, reach your hand down, reaching towards the inside edge of your foot. So your thumb should be right next to your big toe. And we're here. This is our balancing section for this round. So we're finding a little bit of a kick to open up through our hamstrings to release through our quads. So we're just kicking into our hands to to find a nice quad stretch. Heel is aiming towards your glutes, opening up through the front side. We've got two more breaths. Breathe that crown nice and tall, opening up through that shoulder, through that chest. And then as you exhale, maybe find a little more kick to open up through that quad, through those hip flexors. One more. Use your exhale to release through any sensation. On your next inhale, gently release that clasp. Hands come back to midline. Go ahead, pedal out through those feet. Wiggle wobble through those hips as we move into second side. So kickstand through that left leg, growing those roots into our right leg here. Keeping your drishti point, keeping that point of unmoving focus, of concentration. Great perception opportunity as well. We're not judging our body. We're just drilling a hole into wherever that gaze is. Now feel all four corners of your feet pressing in, pressing down. Crown is reaching tall. Now bring that tray out to the left-hand side. Thumb is pointing back, pinky is pointing forward. Again, we're not flipping our tray over. We're staying nice and open through our heart, nice and open through our chest, opening up through our collarbones here. And once you feel balanced, once you feel ready, you have that drishti point, just drop your hand down, clasping the inner edge of that left foot. Left thumb is near your left big toe, shining that heart, feeling the opportunity, and then finding our hamstring and our quad stretch here. So we're finding this by just gently kicking into our hands, staying upright, crown is still reaching tall, opening up through the front side of the body. We've got two more breaths here. Again, sending your inhales to the point of sensation, to the point of tension, to where we're hitting that ledge, and maybe your exhale softens it just a little bit more. One more breath. Let that exhale soften. And go ahead, release that leg. Let your fingertips reach tall, coming into our mountain pose. Exhale, baby back bend, cactus your arms, gaze even goes high. Inhale, reach it tall. Exhale, swan dive it, find your forward fold. Crown of your head goes automatically heavy. Inhale, press into those shins, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come down to the mat, step it back, plank pose. Opportunity to go straight into your down dog or flow through a connecting vinyasa. Come all the way to belly. Tuck your toes, press into the mat, fingertips out wide. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, release. Inhale, press it high and back into your down dog if you're not there already. Big inhale, breath, lift those hips high, reset opportunity. Exhale, let your heart melt, sharing your intention. We're gonna flow breath to movement, breath to body. We've made all these shapes before and we've only got one flow for each of our shapes. We've only got one breath. So make it count. Really stay here, stay in this moment, stay present, and allow yourself to find the perception of our own body, to find this opportunity, to find joy in the movement. On your inhale breath, right leg lifts high to the sky. Exhale with ease, use your entire exhale breath, looking at that point right between your hands. Back heel gets heavy, swoop it up and around. Exhale, land into your warrior two. One, surf it out. Inhale, straighten through that front leg. Reach those fingertips up overhead. Exhale, sit it low. Warrior two. Flip that front palm. Inhale, breath. Reverse warrior. Exhale, cartwheel it towards the top of your mat. Back heel pops up. Inhale, left hand heavy. Right hand twists up and open. Exhale, hand comes down to the mat. Hopping that back foot forward. Inhale, breath, kick it tall. Standing split. Just one Jiva squat, make it count. Exhale, deep bend into both knees, curl it in. Inhale, kick it tall, Jiva squat. or sorry, standing foot. Exhale, soft landing, low lunge. Inhale, step it back, plank pose. Take your time, entire exhale breath, all the way to belly. Tap your toes, press in, fingertips out wide. Inhale, super cobra. Exhale, release. Forehead to the mat. Check in with your perception. Check in with your intention. Tap the toes, curl under, hands back underneath shoulders. Inhale, press it up to plank or tabletop. Hips lift high and back. Downward facing dog. Reset breath here. Breathe into your thoughts. Whatever is holding on. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Next inhale breath, left leg lifts tall. Exhale, take your time, knee to belly, knee to chest. Look at that space right between your thumbs. Step it through. Back heel gets heavy. Inhale, cartwheel it up and open. Exhale, land in your warrior two. Surfing it out once. Inhale, straight front leg, reach it tall. Exhale, sit it low, warrior two. With your front palm, inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, cartwheel it towards the top of your mat. Pop that back heel up. Right hand heavy, left hand hot, flies. Inhale, revolve, low lunge. Exhale, hand to the mat. Walk those palms forward, hop that back foot up. Inhale, standing foot. Exhale, coil it in, Jiva squat. Little change coming up here. Inhale, take a tall standing foot. Exhale, drop your foot to a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Find this reset. Press into your shins, crown reaches forward. Feel those hips realign. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, swoop it up and around. Stand it tall, mountain pose. Exhale, cactus your arms, open it up, baby back bend. Inhale, hands tall. Exhale, hands come down to heart center. Second round of balancing posture. Second round of opportunity here, but maybe finding a little bit more depth. We're gonna move into full dancers. If that is in your practice, feel free to enter it as you can, but starting off the same way. Drop your hand out to the side, holding onto that tray, thumb backwards, crown reaches tall. Exhale, just gently reaching down for that inner foot. Check in, your thumb is next to your big toe, shoulders open, we're not collapsing in on ourselves. And then as you would like, as you inhale, feel that quad stretch starting off already here, kicking in, finding your drishti point. As you inhale, reach that left hand high, finding this nice opportunity to breathe through our heart, breathe through our chest. And then as you exhale, begin to kick. And maybe this time you're kicking so much that you need to reach forward. Kick as much as you can before you begin to tilt. And then once you're kicking as much as you can, find your depth. Once you're there, try and hang on for three big breaths. If you fall out, just come back in. If you lose your breath, allow yourself to take a moment to find it. Keeping your perception, keeping your focus, your balance. Last big breath here, kick a little bit harder. Exhale, gently release the same way you came in. Palms to heart center. Go ahead, dance it out, boogie it out, finding any release you need. Touching your breath, finding this opportunity to reset before we move into second side. Once you're there, if your eyes are closed, flutter them open, find your drishti point, that focus energy point, drill a hole into that with your gaze. All four corners of our right foot pressing in, bring that left hand out to the side, thumbs pointing back, holding a tray. And then as you exhale, just gently put your foot on that tray. So thumb towards the inner edge of your foot. thumb towards big toe, already kicking here, opening up through those hamstrings, opening up, through those quads, through those hip flexors. Inhale, lift that right hand high, reach it tall, and then as you exhale, begin to kick. Finding your kick before you reach forward. Kick, kick, kick. We're here for three big breaths. So allowing yourself to find your sensation, find your mind here. Don't escape. Don't leave. Breathing into the space. Use that exhale to soften. One more big breath. Exhale, gently release. Bring those hands down to heart center. Pedal through those feet. Inhale, swoop it up and around. Exhale, swan dive it. Find your forward fold. Take your time getting here, releasing through that low spine. Inhale, press into a halfway lift. Crown reaches forward, resetting our low spine, our hips here. Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Heel toe your feet in until your toes touch, sliver of space between your heels. And then as you exhale, lift your heels high, coming up onto tippy toes as you drop your seat down, curling into a tiny little ball. Totally opposite position, even letting your crown come to knees, opposite position than dancers. Open big expression into a tiny little internal expression. And then as you exhale, soft landing onto your seat. Yet again, let your hands come to your shins. Pull that heart up and through. Crown reaches tall. And then as you exhale, soft landing all the way onto your back. Take your time to get there. Once you're there, we have got 3 to 4 breaths that are yours. If a supine twist is calling you, you can find 2 to 3 breaths on each side. Maybe some nice gentle windshield wipers, a little bit more movement in that low spine is calling to you. That is what's calling to me. Or stillness, just finding a reset, shortening the distance between your hip bones and your ribs to press that low spine down into the mat. Whichever variation you are taking, don't lose your breath. Don't escape. Stay here. If you're doing one side versus the other, just make sure you balance out. And once you are balanced, let those toes reach forward. Fingertips reach back. Finding a nice, big, deep stretch. Activating every muscle in our body. And then as you exhale, let your feet fall away from each other. Hands fall down to your sides. Eyes fall closed. And then actively release every muscle you're holding on to in your body as you float off into Shavasana. gently begin to bring some awareness back into your space, back into the room, and back onto your mat. Begin to gently reawaken your body by finding a little bit more focus on your breath, by wiggling your toes, tickling your fingers with your thumbs. And then once you feel like you have fully arrived back into your mind, let your toes reach forward, fingers reach back, finding our final big, deep stretch of clasp. From this space, recognize the right or left hand side. Right side for a little bit more energy, left side for a little bit more internal care. Pull your knees towards your chest and gently roll over onto that bicep, whichever side was calling to you. And allow yourself one final breath, one final beat, to allow yourself permission to find the perspective that is going to help you moving forward the rest of your weekend, the rest of your week, year, and life. Now, keeping your eyes closed or your gaze soft, gently press up into a comfortable seated position towards the top of your mat. And once you're there, bring your hands together at heart center, drop your chin towards chest, thanking self first and foremost for giving yourself this hour, this movement, this energy, and this perspective shift. Now bring your hands to that third eye center, lift your chin slightly in a sign of appreciation and awareness of the energy and effort you were able to share. Please know the inner teacher and light within me so appreciates and so recognizes the inner teacher and light within each of you. And one way to say this is to bow our heads and say, Namaste.